Hi, I'm Eric Schmidt with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to talk with us so you can learn more about them. Joining us now is Brett Hyland. He is a candidate for governor. He is seeking the Republican nomination. Thank you for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me, Eric.
Give us a little bit about your background and why you decided to run for governor.
Well, I grew up in the Portland area, and I ended up long-term getting into the financial services industry and starting to pay attention to the public employee retirement system from within the industry. And I decided that that's Oregon's biggest problem, and that it would be a waste of resources for me not to enter the race and try to help solve this problem that's facing our state. It's a catastrophic problem that we're facing.
So while we're on that, let's talk about balancing the budget here in Oregon. It's a big challenge. Yeah. It's always kind of a kabuki dance with the legislature and the governor. You're dealing with PERS, you're dealing with health care, you're dealing with a host of issues. How would you bring some semblance of order, or what would you do to balance the budget?
Well, the biggest issue is the 9,000-pound gorilla that the public employee retirement system funding. Right now, we have a deficit of $24.1 billion. That's the official recognized figure. If you take into account the short funding that we have and the performance of the fund itself, the problem is actually closer to $50 billion. So that is driving the budget. So if you address that one problem, it will allow the rest of the budget to be freed up to address the needs of the rest of the state.
Is the state too reliant on the income tax?
I don't know if too reliant. I would say there are other options, I think, for generating revenue for the state in combination with the income tax that would work.
There are two hot topics that permeate the news these days, gun safety and immigration. What would be the role of the governor if you were elected on those two issues?
Gun safety and regulation?
Immigration,
I'm sorry. Well, I believe in the Second Amendment, and everyone has a right to bear arms, but there are some things that we can do. We can enhance background checks, absolutely. I think gun advocates are in favor of really making background checks work. We can also introduce gun training, as well as gun utilization, as well as gun safety and storage. So those are things that are, I think, a bipartisan win for the state that both gun advocates and those who are looking for greater gun safety measures would agree on.
And immigration.
Immigration, well, that's such a national issue, and we really have very little control over that issue because immigration is controlled by the federal government. And I don't see that we really have a lot of options in terms of how to deal with immigration in the state other than to follow the national lead.
We understand that cap and trade legislation will probably take center stage in the next session of the Oregon legislature. How would you define cap and trade, and what kind of legislation would you like to see regarding it?
It's a government-sponsored market or emissions trading system designed to reduce carbon emissions by assigning some market price to a scarce resource, which would be permits for emissions. And it's proven to be ineffective in reducing emissions. It's also proven not to raise funds for the government. So as well as these permits have lost their value in the secondary market and on thin trading volume. So it's proven ineffective. Well, at the same time, carbon emissions have gone down. So I don't think anytime you open yourself up to a government-sponsored market that's open to industry manipulation as well as to capital market participants manipulating, as well as the state itself changing the dynamics of the market while the market is in operation. I think those are three complex factors that will prove difficult for a cap and trading system. I personally would rather see us be honest about the issue and develop taxation where we all pay to reduce the carbon footprint of our state.
Is this an issue you think the legislature should deal with? If you were elected governor, you'd be part of that.
Well, yes, I think that as it's being talked about, if the legislature chooses to deal with it, then I would definitely be involved in that discussion. I don't see that I would be leading the way on setting up a cap and trade system in the state of Oregon, though.
We live in a highly polarized political climate these days. We also live in a state where there is an urban-rural divide. They kind of go together in some respects. As governor, how would you try to transcend that divide?
It's true, and it's one of the reasons why I decided to enter the race, because I'm a Republican living in Portland, and so I'm a rare breed here, but we're quite a rural state, mostly. And I think that the governor can push for decentralizing the government and pushing more decision-making out to the counties like the state used to be run. And so that can be done, again, by emphasizing what's happening outside of the Portland and, you know, the I-5 corridor, Portland, Salem, Eugene, metropolitan areas. We metropolitan areas are driving the agenda for much of the state, which is quite different than the metropolitan area issues. And so I think pushing decision making out to the county level will be quite helpful and better for the state.
A lot of people live in five areas of the state. The rest of the state is pretty underrepresented population wise.
Yes. They are, but they are not hurting any less than we are here in the city with our homeless issues and our infrastructure issues. They have issues that need to be addressed just as much as our issues.
And we were talking earlier before we started to record that there are 16 candidates for governor this year. What's going to make you stand out?
Well, I've been a leader for a long time. I've been a natural leader. I've led regional and national efforts for large institutions in the financial services industry. And so the biggest problem facing Oregon is this public employees retirement system, $50 billion hole that we have. And I decided that it, reluctantly and out of fear, that the issue might not get addressed properly. And so I reluctantly entered the race to address that issue, primarily because it affects everything in the state. It's an issue that I understand. And so I hope I answered your question there.
We have 30 seconds left.
That's why I did it.
One last word. 30 seconds we have.
Well, I think from that you have to look at the education issue. If you're generous and say 7 out of 10 high school kids graduate from high school, and 4 of those go to college, and out of those 4, 2 or 3 of them graduate from high school, that means that we spend 100% of our resources trying to put two or three kids through college. So that means we need to look at vocation and trades for 7 out of 10 kids in high school, and you know this. We're going to need teachers, but we need to address that huge issue in education as well. I could talk about the infrastructure that we're facing around the state, and especially the traffic here in Portland. That also needs to be addressed.
Well, thank you for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, Eric.
Good to meet you.
You too.